Hello children, today's topic in maths is revision for term 2 exam. So this is the syllabus we are going to follow. The chapters are addition and subtraction. The first topic is addition without carrying. We'll take the example of 254 plus 405. While doing an addition, you should always start with the ones place. What is there in the ones place? 4 and 5. So 4 plus 5 is 9. Then move on to the tens place. What is there in the tens place? 5 plus 0. 5 plus 0 is 5. Then from tens to the, we have to go to hundreds place. What is there in the hundreds place? 2 plus 4. 2 plus 4 is 6. So finally the answer is 659. 254 plus 405 is 659. Next topic is addition with carrying. In addition with carrying also we follow the same procedure, that is adding from ones, then going to the tens, then going to the hundreds. If it is a 4-digit number, then going to the thousands, like that. Let us take an example of 671 plus 265. What is there in the ones place? It is 1 plus 5. What is 1 plus 5? 6. There is no carrying. Next, go to the tens place. What is there in the tens place? It is 7 plus 6. So 7 plus 6 is 13. And 3 is placed here and 1 is carried to the hundreds place. So in the next, going to the hundreds place. What is there in the hundreds place? It is 6 plus 2. 8, but we have already carried 1 to the hundreds place. So 1 plus 6 is 7, 7 plus 2 is 9. 671 plus 265 is 936. Next topic is properties of addition. In that, first property, order property of addition. The sum of two numbers does not change if we change the order. Let us take an example. 55 plus 61 is equal to 61 plus 55. Both the answers will be same. Next property is zero property of addition. Means if we add any number with zero. Let us take an example. 55 plus 0 is equal to 55. So if we add any number with the zero, it is the number itself. And next, grouping property of addition. If we group any numbers, the result will be the same. Let us take an example. 4 plus 3 plus 7. If we do 4 plus 3 is 1 group plus 7 is equal to 4 plus 7 plus 3. Both are same. Next topic is addition word problems. Let us take an example. If a person sells 563, 356 and 253 bells on day 1, 2, 3, then calculate how many total number of bells he sold in these 3 days. This is the working form. First, we have to write the sentences sold on day 1, day 2, day 3. And then we have to do the total, means sum. Addition, 563 plus 356 plus 253 is equal to 1722 bells. So he sold 1172 bells in total. Next topic is subtraction. In that, subtraction without borrowing. While subtracting, we should always start subtracting from the ones place. What is there in the ones place? 4 and 3. 4 minus 3. 1. And next move on to the tens place. In tens place 2 and 1. So 2 minus 1 is 1. And then move to the hundreds place. 8 minus 4 is 4. So what is the answer? The final answer is 411. We have not borrowed anything from any place because the upper numbers are greater than the lower numbers. Next, coming to subtraction with borrowing. Let us take an example of 8163 minus 3678. This also, for subtracting, we have to subtract from the ones place. In the ones place, there are 3 and 8. 3 is less than 8. So we have to borrow from the tens place. In the tens place, what is there? 6. So we will borrow 1 from the tens place. So it becomes 13. 13 minus 8, 5. And next, 5 minus 7. 5 is also lesser. So we will borrow from the hundreds place. From the hundreds place, 1. So we will borrow that 1 also to the tens place. If 1 is also lost means it will become 0. So 15 minus 7 is 8. 0 minus 6, we can't subtract. So from the thousands place, and 8 becomes 7 and 0 becomes the 10. 10 minus 6 is 4 and 7 minus 3 is 4. So finally 8163 minus 3678 is equal to 4485. Next topic is properties of subtraction. There are two properties. First one is zero property. If we subtract zero from any number, the difference is the number itself. Example, 35 minus 0 is 35. And the next property is the number property. If we subtract a number from itself, the difference is 0. Example, 53 minus 53 is 0. 56 minus 56 is equal to 0, like that. Next topic is word problems related to subtraction. Let us take an example. A man monthly salary is 12,500 rupees per month. He spends in total of 7,567 for rent, groceries and his children. Find out his monthly savings. Savings means salary minus the amount he spent. And then the remaining amount is the savings. Like if your parents give 10 rupees as a pocket money and you have spent 5 rupees in that, what is your saving in that month? It is 5 rupees. In the same way here, the man spent 7,567 from his salary. So the savings is 12,500 minus 7,567. The conclusion statement is the monthly saving of the man is 4,933 rupees. Next topic is simplification, means involvement of both addition and subtraction. Let us take an example. 567 minus 234 plus 2134. When a question is given like this, we should always do the addition first. Means 567 plus 234, because they are both plus symbols. So what is 567 plus 2143? It is 2701. So next we have to do the subtraction. So 2701 minus 234 is equal to 2467. So always do the addition symbols first and then the subtraction. Thank you. All the best.